Uncle, I'm home!
Oh, my nephew. You've returned.
Yes, Uncle. And I have news for you.
Have a seat. What happened on your journey?
Well, Uncle, you're no longer the richest man in the city.
Oh, that's okay. Nephew, we don't need
to. Actually, you're the richest man in the entire kingdom.
I am?
You were wise, Uncle, to trust me to do your business on your behalf. I made a deal with a rich gold miner, and now we own half the gold in this land. What are you doing?
I'm dancing for the Lord.
Oh, of course.
Praise you, God. Praise your holy name. Thank you for blessing us.
Yeah. Praise you, God. And Uncle, will you bless me? Will you reward me for the great thing that I have done?
What reward do you seek?
Promote me to chief banker. Let me oversee your fortune, and I'll make us, I mean, you, even richer.
It will be done after our journey.
What journey?
Something great is happening, nephew. The stars, the planets, the scripture. God has spoken to me through all of these. A new star has risen, the birth of a king, our king. We will go and find him, then worship him.
Our king?
The king of all the Jews. Well, the king of all kings. He will only be a child, and I plan to give him everything we have.
What?
Everything we have, yes.
No, wait. Uncle, you are known for your wisdom, but have you thought this through?
Nephew, you have served me well, and you are like my son. Now trust me. In order for us to worship our king, we must give him everything we have.
But, Uncle, this means traveling across the desert. You're too old for this. You'll waste your life.
This will be the greatest waste of my life. Let's get going.
Wow, Uncle. Just a few things, huh?
Just a few gifts for the king.
Can I see? Food. Spices. Perfect. Diapers. What's this?
A Walmart gift card.
Seriously?
Nephew, we need to hire a guide for our journey. Here is enough to hire the best guide in the land. Please, go and find him.
I need to purchase a slave. Are any of you for sale? You there, how much are you worth? You must be kidding. What about you? You would sell yourself that cheap? 10 dimes? Must be some sort of scam. You there. Stand up, please. Are you for sale? I can't hear you. Can you speak? You're a mute? Come here so I can take a closer look at you. Your name's Rocco. The fact that you can't speak may be a good thing. How well do you know the desert between here and Judea? That's good. That's perfect, in fact. I'd like to buy you. Rocco, can you keep a secret? I know you can. You can't talk. You see, my uncle is a very rich wise man. He's also very old and blind and beginning to go a little crazy. He wants to give everything we own to some so-called newborn king in a faraway land. Truth is, I'm the one who does all the thinking in our family. Can't let him do this, Rocco. He's forcing me to go on this journey, and he thinks I'm hiring a guide. I need you to pretend to be that guy. But lead us in circles so that we get nowhere and eventually have to return home. Can you do this? Of course you can. And if you do your job, when we get home, I will give you this. But for now, I will have to hide it. Do we have a deal?
Let's take a break.
Uncle, I have to tell you something. I don't believe in this dream. I don't believe in this king, and I don't believe you're a wise man. You'll give your fortune away to a nobody if we don't die on the way to find him.
Don't worry, nephew. God is with us, and nobody is going to die.
Turn back now.
We're halfway there. There is no sense in turning back. God goes ahead of us.
All you do is talk about God. How do you know he's even real? How do you know he cares about us? I've never seen God. Never heard him speak. You're just a foolish blind man.
Son, the Lord speaks to you. You must always be listening. He speaks in mysterious ways. It is different for everybody. Now everyone, get up. We must press on. Rocco, we need you to carry all of our things. Come on, nephew, stay with me a little longer.
Water. We need water. God, help us.
Thank you.
are you doing? Water! Uncle, wake up! Uncle! No! There's water, come on!
Praise God!
My prayer! God heard me. He answered my prayer.
He's real, nephew.
God heard me. Rocco, wake up! Bandits, we're being robbed!
Rocco, protect our stuff! Fight them!
It's okay, guys. I got this. I've been learning some self-defense. What is this? It's called Kaju Kembo. Well, actually, Kaju Kempo is a hybrid martial arts using techniques from karate, judo, kempo, and both Western and Chinese boxing. It actually started over 70 years ago.
Yeah? You're born into death. Keep going.
Well, it's actually quite fascinating how they involve all
Enough.
The different...
We're not afraid of that kempo jumbo thing. We're taking everything with us. And don't try to stop us if you don't want to get hurt.
Nephew, don't let them take the gifts for our king.
Sorry, Uncle. I thought I could scare them off. I've read about Kaju Kembo, but I've never actually practiced it.
Nephew, pray with me. God, help us.
Let's get out of here!
It's the star. I've seen it before. It's a sign given for the birth of our king. We should follow it.
But the bandits took all the gifts.
We still have the gold. Let's leave now. We're all halfway there.
Before King Herod, Uncle.
Thank you. Thank you. I know why you're here. You've come to ask me, where is he who is born King of the Jews?
How did you know?
Well, you're not the first. There were two just like you here a week ago.
Please, Your Greatness, will you tell us which way to go?
Old man, You don't need to go anywhere. You found what you're looking for. I am the king of the Jews.
You're not the...
Oh! Wow! Uncle! We found him! It was King Herod all along. It is so nice to meet you.
Oh, I know.
You should have heard my uncle talk about how he couldn't wait for this moment. It's his lifelong dream. You know, he's pretty much blind, so he didn't recognize you at first. Dreams come true, don't they? Well, we should probably start heading back because it's a long journey home. So, Uncle, what do you say we stop bothering King Herod and head back home now?
You're not the king we're looking for.
A blind wise man searching for an infant king. How ridiculous. Look, I get it, guys. You're religious. I'm all about that. Freedom of religion, man. That's great. In fact, how about you go find this king, and then you come back here. Tell me where he's at so that I can go and worship him with you.
Thank you, Herod. We will come back and tell you.
Oh, I know you will, because you're leaving your slave in the treasure chest here with me until you return. Well, what are you waiting for? Off you go. See you guys soon. We'll be waiting right here.
Another one has come.
Welcome. I'm Mary. This is my husband Joseph, and this is Jesus.
Have you come from the east?
Yes. We followed a star.
Then you must be here for him.
Your home is very nice.
It's not much, but God has provided us with all of this. Others came like you to see him.
God blessed us. Jesus is a miracle. An angel visited me before I was pregnant and told me I would have a son, and he'd be called the Son of God.
An angel also visited me in a dream, and he told us that Jesus would save us from our sins.
He's the King of Kings, God on earth, and he lives in a small home among the poor. We were going to bring you gifts, but it was all taken from us on our journey.
Uncle, I have something to give. I still have the gold you gave me at the market before we left.
You didn't spend this on Rocco?
I lied to you, Uncle. Rocco was just a cheap slave, not a guide. I wanted us to get lost, so that we would return home. I didn't trust you, Uncle. I'm sorry. I don't deserve to be here with you. I don't deserve to look at him.
Thank you.
All my life, I have lived in darkness. Now I can see a very bright light.
I miss Rocco.
Yeah, me too.
Even though he was pretty much useless to us.
And he smelled funny.
I still miss him.
I would like to rescue him, but...
Yeah, let's talk about it in the morning. Good night.
I'm dreaming?
Yes.
You are an angel?
Yes, and I have a message for you from God. Don't go back to Herod. The Lord is taking care of Rocco. Return to your home.
Is Jesus truly the king?
You have said it correctly. Jesus is truly the king. For this reason he was born, and for this he has come into the world to tell the truth. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Oh, okay. Do dogs go to heaven?
I can't tell you.
Dang, I really wanted to know.
I think I'm getting a headache.
Here. Try these.
Wow. That's better. I think I'm going blind, Uncle.
And I couldn't be more proud. Nephew, keep the glasses. I haven't needed them since the night we saw Jesus.
You know, I can't stop thinking about Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. I pray for them every day.
That's good. They should be in Egypt by now, out of Herod's reach. Rocco!
Is it really you?
It says, Herod sold him to a wealthy king in India. Rocco saved the king from choking to death, so the king freed him. The king became very sick, but Rocco remained at his side. Before dying, the king declared Rocco a prince and gave him his kingdom to inherit. So, you've come back to us to become our slave again?
Forgive my uncle Rocco. He spent a little too much time in the desert. You know, we almost have nothing left since we lost everything to Herod. If you'd find it in your heart to show us some compassion, King Rocco, let us have a place in your court. Let us work for you. We're both educated men, as you know. He says yes.
Praise you, God, our mighty God. Praise your holy name!
Is written with angels singing. Oh, 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 oh gospel song and open up your eyes, the celebration starts in